Hello and welcome to Braintree High School for today's exclusive coverage of boys varsity basketball as your Braintree Wombs take on the Natick Redhawks. Mike Wassel here for BCAM TV and Braintree coming in off of a big win over arch rival Weymouth 58-57, a game in which Braintree led comfortably for most of it before Weymouth gave Braintree all they could handle in the end. So the Wombs coming off a big win over Weymouth and actually their second win in a row, as they now move to 5-5 on the season. So now we'll give you the starters here. First for Natick,
Number three, Peter Ryan.
Senior, number four, Chris Cardozo.
Junior,
number 11, Jake Arold. Senior, number 13, Sean Parks. And to round it out, a junior number 30, Willie Broditsky. Now for Braintree. No surprise here for the Wombs. To start things off, number 10, Marco Carnes. At forward, number 21, Alex Kennedy. At forward, number 23, Anthony Peacock. At guard, number 24, Aiden Convoy. And playing, actually usually jump, but he is a guard. Number 25, Nick Timberlake, head coach Robert Crook, and team manager BK. So we're set for basketball here at the Herger Gymnasium. Braintree trying to get over the 500 mark, standing at 5-5 on the season. And again, the starters here today, Ryan Cardozo, Arold, Parks, and Broditsky for Natick. And for Braintree, Carnes, Kennedy, Peacock, Convoy, and Timberlake, as Timberlake set to jump with Broditsky. Braintree trying to win their third consecutive game, trying to make a run for the postseason. Going to need at least four more wins to get in as they win the draw right at the tip and inside to Peacock as it's bobbled, and now it's come down with by Natick as Braintree not able to convert. So Braintree missing a golden opportunity. Coming down with it is Kennedy, and Braintree back the other way, Convoy. Convoy right inside to the cup and lays it off the glass for two. Big 2 points for Braintree to start things as Convoy, a good sign to get him on the score sheet. Close to a travel as driving inside, tough floater is no good as Cardozo misses, and Braintree will have possession on the out-of-bounds play. 7:17 to go in the first, Braintree up 2-0. Womps able to get it over half court into the hands of Timberlake. Looking for the lob pass, and it's too short for Timberlake, who is wide open. Braintree tried that play against Weymouth, and it actually worked, but it wasn't as fluid as you would like. Driving inside, the tough shot off the opposite foot, and Brodnicki with the offensive rebound to put it back in. So right now a little bit sloppy on the Braintree side with a turnover and a missed balk out. Inside, the floater from Carnes able to kiss it off the glass for two. Braintree back on top, 4-2. Picking it outside to Arold, and now the quick movement around the perimeter. Arold with it inside the paint, kicks it outside, and just a few seconds on the shot clock. 5 seconds to go as Ryan has to do something with it. Sends it inside and it's turned over again. Good defense by Braintree. Kennedy back the other way. Nice pass inside Timberlake, and he can't squeeze it over the rim as that one is no good. And Timberlake comes right back to come up with the steal, and he got fouled from behind. Timberlake, after getting fouled, was warned by the referee for delay of game. As he threw it off the glass, he wanted to go on the fast break, and he was fouled from behind. There really wasn't much contact. As we have the first team foul of the game, that one on Natick. Screened by Peacock, looking to roll inside. Nice pass, and it's going to be two free throws for Peacock, who nearly converted the play inside. So Braintree right now has started to find a little bit of inside presence in the form of Peacock, and that translated over from the Weymouth game, where Peacock was able to score 12 points, and all 12 of the points came on layups right inside of the paint. Peacock fakes the shot, now is in a little bit of traffic, goes high off the glass, no good, gets his own rebound, sends it outside, and Braintree will have a fresh shot clock. Kennedy back up top to Conboy, and Avery into the game for the first time. With possession, drives inside and loses control and now throws it away. Back the other way as Ryan goes inside. Tough shot with the left hand, it's no good. And Braintree coming down with the rebound for the moment. And then it's knocked out of play by Avery off his leg. 5:10 to go and a very low scoring first quarter. So Braintree has had very good looks here in the first, but they just have two field goals to show for it. Nick right now doing just enough to disrupt some of Braintree's shots. Otherwise, Braintree would have a commanding lead here in the first quarter. Ryan driving inside, and the foul is away from the play right before the shot, as that was on Vanelli, his first. At half court, good defense by Vanelli. Driving inside the paint and now kicked outside to Kerry. Kerry sends it cross court and throws it away. And Natick very sloppy here in the first quarter. That is their third turnover already. Definitely not the start you expected if you are Braintree on the offensive side, but the defense has been excellent. But now it's time to capitalize on these mistakes by the Redhawks. Head coach Sam Donner trying to get his team to really settle down. And if they continue to play this way here in this game, they're going to get blown out very quickly. So they're going to have to change it up quick. As Vanelli up top, Timberlake, and now Avery steps into the three, and he missed it as Guy was battling for the rebound and is taken down by Carey. So Braintree with another miss on a pretty good look from the outside. The shot is no good from the three-point line by Brodnicki as Avery comes down with a rebound and gets it over to Vanelli, who gives it right back. Bullet pass inside, and it was nearly tipped up and in. That was certainly not the intended play, as that was nearly knocked in by Quigley, who just got a piece of the ball inside. The right-handed shot is good, and Braintree will take a timeout as they are all out of sorts on offense with the game tied at 4 with 3:59 to go here in the first quarter. So just 4 points for Braintree, 2 by Carnes, and 2 by Conboy. Ryan with two, Fornadik, and Brudnitsky with two. So just 2 points as the leading scorer, and a little bit surprising for a Braintree team that can certainly score in bunches. The last game against Weymouth, they only scored 58, but they've hit the 65-point mark in pretty much every game this season. They've hit 78 and 80 already this season as well, so they can certainly score, but right now they got to find a way to get some baskets to stay down. They've gotten quality looks here in this first quarter, just haven't had them stick. Braintree all set. Out of their timeout, it'll be Quigley, Avery, and Timberlake in the front court, or in the back court, and Finelli and Guy, who just entered in up front. Braintree looking to run a play into the hands of Quigley as Avery now drives inside, kicks it over to the free throw line for Finelli. The shot no good, and Braintree battling for the rebound, wasn't able to come down with the offensive rebound. Up high off the glass, the tip from Errol, no good. And Timberlake on the move, all the way inside to the basket and couldn't finish at the rim as it goes out of play off of Braintree. So Timberlake 0-2 here in the first quarter. And he'll take a seat as Conboy will come in. So a rare sluggish start for Braintree as a team, and certainly for Timberlake. Nidic having all set, sort of trouble in the backcourt trying to get the ball in. Just able to get it in before that 5 second mark. Brodnitsky wide open three, no good. And the rebound taken down by Conboy. Braintree has numbers moving forward. Conboy inside, nice pass to Guy. Little two footer is good. And Braintree back on top, 6-4. Right now, Braintree making the extra pass inside. That time it worked. Now it's a time to go on a run. Inside Ryan, tough shot. Good defense by Avery, and it's loose. And Braintree able to knock it away. Here goes Conboy all the way inside and not able to get the shot off. Now he is, but he's fouled. A late whistle. That actually hurt Natick because I thought it was going to be a jump ball, and they let him play. And then Natick ended up turning it over, so it hurt him big time as Braintree was on the move, and now we'll get two free throws as Conboy looks to add to his 2 point total here in the first quarter. First free throw is good as McNeil checking in for the first time and Kennedy checking back in for Avery and Guy. Braintree going small here with 2:45 to go in the first quarter. Probably the biggest player on the court right now for Braintree is Finelli. Conboy 1-for-2 and Kennedy coming down with the offensive rebound. Back to Finelli. As Finelli drives inside, kicks it back up top for Conboy. Not much movement on the perimeter for Braintree. Now it's sent to McNeil, cross court to Quigley. Driving baseline and now back up top. Finelli, quick movement. Braintree with just 8 seconds on the shot clock. Conboy. The pass to Quigley, the fake. Now the shot and it's high off the glass, no good. And the rebound taken down by Natick. That one was grabbed by DeWitt. Back to the corner. That one inside the three-point line is good. A nice-looking shot from Pereira. And the game is now a one-point game, 7-6 Braintree. Right now, no starters really getting the job done on the offensive side for either team. We've seen both teams have to go onto the bench early in this game, trying to find a spark. Quigley again, Braintree using a lot of clock, 10 on the shot clock outside. Finelli didn't want to take the shot, now it's thrown away. Braintree a little gun shy here in the opening quarter. So this one, a 5 o'clock start. Most of the games here at home are 6:30 starts. So certainly starting earlier than usual. You wonder if that has an effect on the mentality, but Braintree needs to get it together here as they trail for the first time. It's 8-7. Hand off to Conboy looking for the basket, and the kiss shot is good off the glass as Convoy leads the team with scoring with now five. Peacock and Novo set to check in here in the final minute on the next whistle. Nine to eight, Braintree with the lead. 10 on the shot clock for Natick. Back to the top of the key, and a good look from the outside. It's no good, and the rebound taken down by Kennedy. Braintree can just about hold for the final shot. It'll be about an 8 second differential between shot and game clock. The shot is good, and Vannelli was fouled. Count the basket, and a chance for a three-point play. Very rarely do you see a shooter knocked down like that on the follow-through. And Vannelli was able to convert the play, getting his first points of the quarter. And he can certainly score, but right now here in the first quarter, he's been a little bit gun-shy. Had a couple looks from the outside, and he can knock down that three-point shot. But he passed it up a few times and now misses the free throw. So Braintree up by three. It's 11-8. Back the other way as Natick has a chance to hold for the final shot, but they don't seem to want to as they drive inside. And it's thrown away. Convoy getting it over to McNeil with the final 6 seconds. McNeil, the basket, tough shot. No good. Novo with the offensive rebound. Put up. And he got fouled. And that will be two free throws before the whistle. So this is how the quarter will come to a close unless they put a couple tenths of a second, which they should, because obviously that one was shot before the end of the quarter. So it doesn't look like they'll put any time on. It'll just be two free throws for Novo to end this quarter. So Braintree with a chance to go up by five with the pair, as the first free throw is no good. And Braintree continuing to struggle from the free throw line this season. So far, they've only made one out of the three. Make it now two out of four. So Novo splitting the free throws, and that's how the first quarter comes to a close. And Braintree up 12-8, so not a great first quarter for Braintree, but they'll take it with a four-point lead as we head to the second quarter. We'll be back for second quarter action here on BCAM TV right after this.
You might feel like there's too many problems in the world, or that, you know, you as a 15-year-old, 16-year-old can't really make a difference.
It's not always about you. It's not just one person. It's a group. It's a team.
Just that simple act is transforming someone else's life.
It's one of the best feelings in the world.
It'll just make you feel so good about yourself.
I'd do anything to convince you just to be a part of this.
Start of the second quarter here at Braintree High School. The Wamps up by four, 12-8. Mike Wassel here for BCAM TV and the Wamps. Right now we'll play on defense to begin the quarter. Ended it pretty well. After trailing 9-8, they were able to get the final 4 points. That's Braintree with the foul, their second team foul. Natick has five team fouls so far here in the first half. Into the corner is Cardozo. Cardozo to Eralds, back to Ryan. That's a three, and it's no good. And the rebound goes out of bounds off Eralds, back to Braintree. So Braintree has gone to the bench early and often here in the first half. So right now the five on the court after the substitution of bringing in Carnes will be Kennedy with Novo, Peacock, and also the Wamps have Timberlake, or rather Convoy out there, as that one is out of play off of Braintree and another turnover. So now is Timberlake who's going to check in for Novo. So the Braintree Wamps right now really changing it up strategy-wise, not really giving anybody a ton of minutes here in this first half and getting everybody involved, which obviously is a good sign, but you would certainly like a little bit more play from your starters. Try and get yourself a little cushion before halftime. driving inside, and that one knocked away by Conboy, nearly coming up with a steal inside and close to a travel as the shot's no good, and now the home run pass is too far for Carnes. And Carnes running into the wall there may have hurt himself a little bit as he hit the padding, shaking up a little bit. One of the most sluggish starts Branch has had this season. Just 12 points. As Carnes has whistled for the foul. Trying to be a little bit too aggressive. And got a piece of the hand on the reach-in foul. Third team foul for Braintree. 6.5 to go in the second quarter. Lobbed inside and not converting is Ryan. That was a beautiful setup. Should have been finished on the layup. Both teams missing easy shots here in the first half. Peacock to Timberlake trying to get things going, and he throws it to Kennedy, who wasn't looking. Frenchie fortunate to get the ball back. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Inside Peacock. Peacock off the glass, no good. And the rebound is going to be controlled by Carnes. Carnes up off the glass, no good. Peacock, offensive rebound, no. Another offensive rebound, Kennedy. Timberlake now in the corner. And that shot's off, and Braintree has really struggled on the offensive end. Back the other way, tough shot. And Timberlake is going to be whistled for the foul on the acrobatic shot by Kanuga. And now it looks like maybe a technical foul on Natick away from the play. So it looks like Arold will get a technical foul, which in that situation there's really no need for. Usually you see a technical on the team that had committed the foul. So very surprising there as Natick is whistled for the tee. Still 12-8 the score, which is where we stood at the end of the first quarter. So neither team has scored so far here in the second. And it still stays that way after the first missed free throw. Finally, our first points of the quarter, as knocking down one out of two to make it 12-9. And now Branchie will get a free throw on the other end, and it'll be Timberlake looking for his first of the game as well, which he gets. So Timberlake will get two. And we'll see if this gets him going. Doesn't take much to get Braintree's most potent scorer going as he knocks down both free throws. And Braintree now with a 5-point lead, 14-9, and now they'll have the basketball. Braintree turning it over. Pass to the outside. A good look from the perimeter. And Natick missing another open look. Neither team has been able to hit an outside shot yet. As Braintree will set up the offense as Carnes tries to get it over half court. And now is guilty of a violation in the back court, and that just can't happen. Frenchie was not able to get it over half court in the allotted time, and that is just a big mental mistake. Now Braintree just sluggish on all sorts of plays here in this first half, which is very surprising. This does not look like the Womp team that was primed for a big run in the postseason. Right now they're struggling just to even get to the postseason. They're standing at 500 right now. Another team foul on Braintree. That one is on Conboy, and that's Braintree's 15th foul. So Natick will inbound under Braintree's basket. Pass inside, and Conboy may have gotten a piece of that, but he certainly altered the shot by Cardoso. And now Timberlake to the glass, and he puts it in. So Timberlake now with a quick 4 points here in the second quarter. Nice look inside, and the shot is good by Brodnicki, who has four, and a foul in the backcourt as Conboy was hit in the face. And that is the 17th foul, so it's a one-on-one situation now for Braintree. Not really a good foul in the backcourt by Cardozo. So Vanelli checking back in for Kennedy. 4:45 to go in the second quarter. Braintree up by five and a chance to add. One-on-one situation for Conboy, and he knocks down the first. 6 points for Aiden. Right now, 2 for 3 from the line here in the half. Make it 3 for 4. He's got 7. As Quigley will come in for Conboy, who has played probably one of his better offensive halves of the season. 7 already points here in the first half as the layup is good. Back the other way, that was a quick pass, and DeWitt, the beneficiary of a nice pass. 18-13, we'll see if the scoring starts to pick up. Carnes has swallowed up, and now Braintree needs a timeout. So we'll take a break. 4:30 to go here in the second quarter, and Braintree on top by 5, 18-13. Braintree sent to inbounds. 4.5 to go in the second quarter. Mike Wassel here for BCAM TV, and Braintree up 5 as Quigley gets it inbounds to Carnes. Carnes, beautiful pass, Peacock, and he lays it off the glass for 2. Peacock's first 2 of the game on a nice pass from Carnes. Back the other way as it's knocked outside by Errol to Brodnicki. Beautiful find inside, and Brodnicki blew the layup. That was a beautiful pass as he went back door and had a great look at the basket. Braintree up 7 with their largest lead so far here of the game. Carnes looking for the interior pass to Peacock, and now he turns it over. And that's quickly going to get Avery into the game as Braintree continuing to make mental mistakes here in the first half. A lot of contact on both sides, and now the whistle is on Vanelli. So Avery checking in for Carnes with Braintree up by 7. Noval also checking in along with Leahy. Inside Brodnicki, and the shot is good as Peacock came over to challenge and wasn't able to alter that shot. Brodnicki, the leading scorer for Natick, with 6. Novo. And he got fouled and was bailed out. That would have been a tough shot. He was caught in the air, and Natick committing the foul on the arm. Elbow knocking down the first, 2 for 3 so far here in the game from the line. Both he and Kennedy, or rather he and Conboy, 3 for 4 from the line. As the initial shot is missed, and the putback is good. So Brodnicki, again, has been a difference on the glass. Cross-court pass to Peacock. Interior look for Quigley is no good. Natick back the other way. Outside, Ryan, a clean look for 3, no good. And that one battled up there, and Novo coming down with the rebound into the hands of Avery. Timberlake and Kennedy getting ready to check back in. Leahy to Quigley. Quigley driving inside, back to the top of the key. Novo fakes it, now takes it just inside the line. The free throw line, that is, and knocks it down. So Novo very quickly with five. And Brodnicki running the court, finding the big man. He's got 10. First player in double figures. Quigley, and he has it knocked away. Franchi with another turnover. 24-19 as the scoring has picked up big time here in the quarter. A bunny missed, and now another miss by Brodnicki as Natick has missed two easy shots on the possession. And Sam Donner looking for a foul, and there was none coming. Rantry was guilty of stepping out of bounds as Leahy came across. Back outside as Cardoso has really struggled here in the first half and continues. He has yet to hit a shot. He's 0-4. Novo inside. Tough shot is good as he's able to squeeze that one in. So Novo, an impressive 7 points here in the first half to tie Convoy as the leading scorer. Now it's taken away. Convoy, and here comes Timberlake back the other way for the two-handed flush, but he's not able to convert. And Timberlake all out of sorts here in the first half on the offensive ends. Outside to Convoy. Convoy for three. No good. And Timberlake with another chance. This time he has it knocked away from behind. Inside. Tough shot for Cardozo, and finally gets his first points. And Natick will take a timeout as they've crawled back to within five. It's 26-21 with a tick over a minute to go in the second quarter. So Braintree getting some offense from some unlikely sources here in the first half. Novo with seven, and Convoy with seven as well. So Braintree not getting it from the usual suspects here in the first half. Timberlake has just four. And Peacock with just 2 points as well. So Braintree getting the secondary scoring, which hasn't been the way things have gone all season. But here in this game, they've gotten the production from some players that really generally don't do most of it. But in certain game situations when your go-to players are struggling from the field, that is what you need. And that's what Braintree's gotten here in the first half to give themselves a five-point lead. And you certainly expected a higher output here in this first half by Braintree, but they've had a much better second quarter than they did in the first. So far they've scored 14 in the quarter. They had 12 back in the first. But Natick has battled right with Braintree. They scored 13 here in this quarter after just 8 in the opening. Kennedy, Avery, Convoy, Novo, and Timberlake, the five out there for Braintree. Avery over to Timberlake and back up top to Convoy. Nearly turned over, and now it's loose in the feet, and it is turned over as Braintree giving it away. The initial head fake by Arold, able to get the defender to fly by, and he puts it off the glass for his first two. Braintree up by just three. Avery corner to Timberlake, fakes the shot, now takes the shot inside the line and knocks it down. Timberlake with just his second field goal of the half, 16 points. As that one was tied up, and now it's a jump ball going in favor of Braintree. 16 seconds to go, and Braintree will have a chance to hold for the final shot. Right now leading by five, trying to knock down another basket. Go up seven, maybe even eight with a knockdown three. Convoy in the final 6 seconds. Out into the corner, Novo. Tough shot is good. And Novo ends the quarter with a nice jumper as he finishes the first half with 19 points. So going along with a couple steals and a couple rebounds, and Braintree leads by seven after two quarters of play here at Braintree High School. So Braintree trying to get over 500, trying for their sixth win of the season, and right now a 7-point lead at half, 30-23. We'll take a break and bring you back third quarter action here on BCAM TV right after this. Welcome back to the Herc Gymnasium. Start of the third quarter. Mike Wassel here for BCAM TV, and the Wamps leading by 7 as we enter the third quarter, 30-23. As Branchio scored Natick 18-15 in that second quarter, after outscoring Natick by 4 in the opening quarter. Both teams able to heat it up a little bit in that second quarter on the offensive end. And the first play of the second quarter is a steal, or the third quarter is a steal by Timberlake. And he wasn't able to finish at the cup. Branchy with a couple of chances there as Carnes misses. And back the other way. A tough floater is good by Peter Ryan, who now has 4 points in the game. Branchy back the other way as Timberlake looking inside. Tough pass for Peacock, and Branchy fortunate that one went out of play. That was what could have been a steal by Parks, who was open. Inside to Peacock. Peacock, a six-footer is good. So Peacock's second basket of the game. The junior forward trying to really make his role on his team as Branchy with another steal. Kennedy having trouble with it for the moment. Conboy now to the other side for Timberlake. Timberlake inside, high and off the glass for two. Make it 8 points now in the game for Timberlake, and another mistake by Natick bringing the ball up. With 6:55 to go here in the third quarter. Braintree starting off the second half well. Able to get it over half court into the hands of Kennedy. Beautiful pass, but Peacock couldn't handle it. It was a good idea by Kennedy, but he threw it to the tallest man on the court. And it was down around the shin of Peacock. Carnes coming from behind to knock it away. And Natick not aware in that situation. Branchy looking for the entry pass. It is to Peacock. Peacock off the glass for two. A nice little play inside. That's 6 points now in the game for Anthony Peacock. Cardozo had his arm around, and that's a travel. He had his arm around Conboy and could have been called for the offensive foul on a hook. Instead, he's whistled for a travel. So either way, things have not gone the way of Natick here in this third quarter. And they continue to make mental mistakes, and that's going to really cost him in this game, which it already has. But it's really going to get Braintree going. Braintree's right now starting to balloon their lead. Right now standing at 11 points, their largest lead of the game. First time they've been in double figures. And this has been a Braintree team that from game to game has shown different ways of winning. But this has been one of their uglier games so far this season. But right now trying to turn that all around and play a solid second half. Probably their most impressive win this season came back actually on opening night where they played Norwood. They won 80-61, and that one was really never close, even though it was a 19-point game. Braintree was up by 30 for most of that game. They also had a pretty solid win over Framingham, a 21-point win there, and they beat Dedham big time back a couple weeks ago by 30. So Braintree's had a couple good wins, and then they've had a couple tough losses mixed in, the 3-point loss to Brookline earlier in the season, and they'll get a chance back with Brookline in just a couple days. Carnes just able to get it over half court, over to Peacock. Peacock up off the glass, and he wasn't able to get the shot off, and it's a jump ball. So Peacock was trying to lay that one off the glass, and the defender was able to tie him up, but Braintree fortunate enough to keep possession. Inbounded to Carnes, had it knocked away, fighting for it, and now it's gotten over to Kennedy. Kennedy cross court to Timberlake. Timberlake a three, and it's good. Timberlake finally able to knock down an outside shot for Braintree, and he now has 11 points. He's very quickly gotten into double figures. So Timberlake doesn't take much to get going, and if he has a good second half, this one is just all but done for Natick. Kennedy baiting for the steal, didn't get it, and now it's turned over again. Back the other way, Timberlake, off the glass, two more. Natick falling behind now by 16 points after what was a 7-point game at half. Carnes got a lot of ball. We whistled for the foul, but that was an alert play from Carnes in that situation based on the lack of ball security for Natick here in the third quarter. He was going for another steal. Right now, Natick needs to do a better job of securing the ball as that one knocked away by Conboy as Brodziski was going up. Conboy and the blocking foul as Conboy got it ahead to Timberlake. And there was no shot on the play. Just the first team foul on Natick as Braintree's going to get some substitutions in. As Vanelli and Avery coming back in for both Kennedy and Carnes. Vanelli has his pass deflected. Peacock comes down with it, lets the defender go by and puts it in. 8 points now for Peacock. That was just a veteran play, allowing the defender to just go right by him and able to put that one up off the window for two more. Foul. We'll see if it's before the shot. I think it's on the floor. The foul is on Vanelli, and that is his third. Braintree picking up their second team foul here in the third quarter. And Braintree has blown this one open here in the second half. So whatever was said by Coach Crook at halftime after the missed shot, now for Natick and a rebound by Peacock. Braintree has gotten the message as convoyed all the way inside for two more and a foul. If you tuned in, this is not the way Braintree played in the first half, but they have come to play here in the second half and have really taken control, now up by 20. No good on the free throw as Peacock battling for it. Not able to come down with the offensive rebound. Back the other way. And Peacock, oh, what a play. He got that one high off the glass with a nice block, and now he's able to knock it away. That is excellent defense shown by Peacock. Peacock, game to game, usually the tallest man on the court, and was able to come up with a big time rejection. That's really what he's known for on defense, as a shot blocker. Shot is no good, and another rebound by Conboy. Braintree back on the move. They've been able to get some good passes, and there's another one. Peacock for two more. That's 10 in the game, and Braintree up by 22. They are on a big run. 2 points so far here for Natick in the third quarter. Braintree has come out firing. They've scored 17 already here in the third quarter. So a 17-2 run. And that one was bad for Natick. That was just a bad miscommunication. Guerrero is looking back door. And the Redhawks were not on the same page as Ryan was cutting, looking for the pass. 3:17 to go in the third quarter. Convoy getting it. The return pass inside, looking for Peacock. Peacock struggling for the second. Gets it out to Vannelli. Fakes the shot. Now he'll take it, and no good. Rebound taken down as Smudin gets it over. And the three-point shot is no good. Rebound taken down. Vannelli, Branchy looking to get in transition. Ahead for Quigley, and Quigley not able to come down with the pass. Smudin right into the shot. Off the glass, no good. Another rebound for Convoy, his sixth rebound. Convoy wide open. Quigley. Quigley's first two of the game, and Convoy right now looking like a great facilitator. Oh, what a play by Convoy to at least save it. A three-point shot from the outside, no good. And another offensive rebound, this time for Natick, as Smudin will now see a timeout. And Natick really just falling apart here in this third quarter. Braintree has scored already 19 points here in this third quarter with 2:12 to go. And Braintree has certainly taken control here in the second half. And this has been a game, if you look at the schedule, this is one that Braintree has to win if they want to make a run for the postseason, which obviously they want to do. And this, assuming the score will hold here in this second half, Braintree will pick up their sixth win of the season to get over 500. And they'll need three more wins on their following schedule. To make it into the postseason. Right now, Braintree just had 18 games scheduled. A little bit surprising. Generally, they try and get 20, but this year, they were not able to get the additional two. Usually, Braintree ends the season with the Sharon Tournament. It's actually called the Davenport Classic, played around Valentine's Day. But this year, Sharon was not doing that tournament, and Braintree wanted to host one of their own, but they weren't able to get anybody to play them. So Braintree was not able to schedule two more games on their schedule. So now they have to win half the games, which with 18, they'll have to win 9. So it works for you and against you. But it doesn't give as much room for the losses in the season as Braintree comes up with another steal. McNeil, Guy, Quigley, Timberlake, and Vannelli, the five out there for Braintree. Final 2 minutes as the entry pass for Guy does not connect. ...49-25, Braintree with the lead. And that one is going to be an offensive foul away from the play as Timberlake was run into. An illegal screen by Brodnitsky. Timberlake so far has 13. He's followed quickly behind by Peacock with 10, Novo and Convoy with 9. So very well balanced here today for Braintree as Novo shut off along the baseline. Gets it over to Timberlake up off the glass. Oh, it was three quarters the way down and it wouldn't stay. Guy trying to challenge that shot, but it's good. Right over the top as Kanuba gets his second and third point of the game. 22-point lead for Braintree. 1:10 to go in the third. Finelli shut off, and now it's back outside. Into the hands now of Timberlake, the three, no good. And Guy, with one hand, is pushed away, and finally a foul. So Guy, strong enough to just ward off the defender, and was able to just battle him and come down with the rebound. So Novo inbounds. Looking for somebody cutting. It is Timberlake. Timberlake, no good. And he comes up with his own rebound for the moment. And now it's knocked away. And Ryan gets it ahead for Smudin. And McNeil able to get a piece, but now it goes out of play. So Braintree has done that a couple times where they've just gotten a piece before the initial shot was going up. And the foul is going to be on Guy. That is the third team foul on Braintree here in the third quarter. 53 seconds left, and a high pass, which is caught and controlled by Ryan. Back to the top of the key now. Broniski, and a two-point shot from Kanuga is no good, and the rebound taken down by McNeil. McNeil challenged in the backcourt, and Braintree will have a chance here on the offensive end. Novo back outside to Vanelli, fakes the shot, takes it, and he got fouled from behind by Smooten. We'll see how much longer the Braintree starters will see the court. Right now, just one starter out there in the form of Timberlake, and we'll see how much longer Braintree keeps some of their starters out there. Vanelli not able to hit the first. Vanelli right now just 2 for 5 from the line. Make it 3 for 6. He's got 3 points in the game. Braintree back up by 23, 50-27. And Natick will have a chance to hold for the final shot. Final 10 seconds now, and the foul is going to be before the shot. And the foul is on McNeil. So that'll be the fourth team foul on Braintree and a fresh shot clock. So now Natick will have 8 seconds left in the quarter, and the shot clock will be shut off. Ryan with it. Looks inside, and a foul. It's going to be on Timberlake. He was hoping the shot was going up, and he was looking for the rejection. And instead, Parks held on. So Parks able to draw the contact here with 4 seconds to go in the third quarter. And Braintree now picking up their fifth team foul. That's the second on Timberlake. First free throw is no good. And neither team really has shot the ball well from the free throw line here in the game. Both free throws no good. Braintree able to get it as the pass, looking to get ahead for Timberlake, is blocked. And that's the way the quarter comes to a close, with Braintree up by 23, able to extend a 7-point halftime lead. And now lead by 23, 50-27 after three. We'll be back for fourth quarter action right after this. Start of the fourth quarter here at the Hugger Gymnasium. Mike Wasson here for BCAM TV, and Braintree leading by 23. Is that one thrown away? Good defense by Braintree on that possession. Just 6 seconds in, and another turnover. So Timberlake, Convoy, Novo out there with Guy. And entering for the first time in the game is Buckley. Outside to Buckley, and Buckley lost control, and now back the other way. One on three and a missed layup, but now a putback is good by Brodnicki. He has 12 in the game. He's been the best player for Natick here today. Outside, Buckley, a good look at a three, and that one's short. Rebound taken down by Parks. Seconds to go on the shot clock. It's down to eight now inside, and the shot is blocked by Guy. 5 seconds left on the shot clock as Brodnicki went down hard. Kanagawa no good, and rebound taken down as Guy gets into the hands now of Convoy. Convoy back the other way. Hands it over to Timberlake. Timberlake, a lot of contact, no call. And that one knocked off, and what should have been a call to travel. Kanagawa has it knocked away from behind, and Nova with another steal. And Convoy again trying to draw contact. He's double teamed, now gets it over to Timberlake. Timberlake inside the paint, and he lays it in. Parks very brave inside, trying to take the charge, and Timberlake able to sidestep him and lay it in. That's 15 now in the game for Timberlake. Frankie back up by 23. Inside, the shot by Ryan is off the mark. And back the other way, Braintree comes. Foul is going to be on Natick, and that is the 16th foul. Martin into the game for the first time as getting free is Timberlake, able to put two more in. He has 17. Back ahead, Brodwitski, and he's fouled from behind. Count it, and one. That's 14 now for Brodwitski. Not able to convert the three-point play as the rebound taken down by Novo. Novo will take the three, and it's well off the mark. One of the few misses in the game for Novo, who's played a solid game. Probably the best he's played all season. .17 left in the game as tempers starting to heat up a little bit in the crowd as a couple of fans starting to get upset with the referees with the lack of calls. So 5:17 to go, Braintree up 54-31. And if you joined us late, Braintree really struggled in the first half, but they did lead by 7. After two quarters, 30-23, but they really were able to balloon this lead in the second half, thanks in large part to Timberlake and Peacock heating up, and Convoy doing a great job facilitating on the offense, finding some open players, getting some easy baskets, and Brantley doing a much better job maintaining possession, not turning it over. Timeout has ended, as is inbounded. Convoy, the lone starter out there for Braintree, as McMartin did a nice job to come away with the steal. getting into the corner for Buckley. Leary back outside for Conboy, just 10 on the shot clock. Outside, Saglieri for three, and no good. That's his shot. He likes that outside shot as Leahy comes up feeling for blood. 4.5 to go in the game. Ryan driving, and he's blocked, and that one went off the outside of the glass, and I think Natick may actually have a beef here because that was blocked, so it should be their own possession. So now the call will be reversed. Cardozo. And that one knocked away by Leahy, who got a hand in there. Leahy with a beautiful feed for Taglieri, who lays it home. That was textbook 2-on-1 up the court, done by Leahy. Branch with the largest lead of the game, 25. It's back down to 23 on the layup, as that one is good by Marks, his first two of the game. Both teams have emptied the bench, with this one obviously in hand. As Branch is going to pick up their sixth win of the season. Down low, and McMartin with it. Outside to Buckley. Buckley in the paint. Buckley, and it's two. Good body control by Buckley as they continue to let him play here in the second half. Down inside, and it's turned over again. And Natick, time after time, turning it over here in the second half. As Buckley, no good. Taglieri is swallowed up, and they're not going to call anything here in this fourth quarter, it seems. Not really sure. Game to game, they've called things so tightly almost every game, and this has been the most they've let the teams play as far as the referees go, which is very surprising, especially with the game well in hand. I mean, you definitely want to let them play a little bit, but I mean, right now they're letting too many things go that are so obvious from here that it's just not even allowing some of the players that don't generally get time to play. I mean, you're taken away from the game. Obviously, the team is up by 23, but still got to allow the reserves to get a chance and allow them to play as if it's a close game. And the referees need to do just that. So with 3:03 to go, Branch up 58-35. Branch will be back at home, as they'll face Brookline in a big, big game. Brookline, at last check, was 7-3. And they already beat Braintree by 3 earlier in the season, a game which Braintree shot so poorly from the line. They actually missed, I believe, 17 free throws in that game. And that was the difference. Braintree trying to go on a run here late in the season, which they've done pretty much every year the last few years. This will be the third consecutive win, as driving inside and missing is Buckley. 2:45 left. 3-point shot, and it's no good. And Natick has yet to hit a 3-point shot here in the game. They've taken plenty of them. McNeil with good aggressive defense, as Carzozo drives along the baseline, sends it outside, another three, and finally one knocked down. Marks now has 5. The lead is 20. 2:20 left. Buckley back up top for Taglieri, who fakes it. Branchy looking to move the ball on offense. Taglieri fakes, now sends it outside McMartin. 8 on the shot clock. Branchy using all 30 of it. McNeil, and he's fouled. Good drive from McNeil, getting inside the paint and getting to the free throw line. Rancher trying to get to that 60-point mark. Chance here with 2. First free throw is good. Just the first point of the game for McNeil. 11 different scores for Braintree here in the game. Second one gets the roll for McNeil. He's got two. Braintree now with 60 points. Drive inside by Marks, and he wasn't able to finish. Leahy thought about the three. Gets it inside to McNeil, back outside Taglieri, and Braintree moving it around the perimeter. He'll use the 30 seconds again, but that one's stolen and back the other way. The layup is good. 60 to 40 with 1:25 to go. Braintree with another turnover. And a travel. .112 left here in the game. Braintree up by 20. And they'll pick up their sixth win of the season to go along with five losses. And that'll put them three wins away from the postseason. Braintree with the third consecutive turnover. So certainly not closing out the game fluidly, but with this one obviously well in hand. A nice save down low by Buckley. And Braintree trying to come up with a good possession here to close it out. McNeil, and he traveled. So four consecutive turnovers for Braintree. Obviously a meaningless situation, but these are players that are trying to fight for more minutes down the stretch, and certainly turning the ball over is not going to help their cause. Down low, McNeil. There's a 7 second differential between shot and game clock, so Branch will have to put it up one more time. Make it five straight turnovers for Braintree. And back the other way, down low, beautiful look. And the layup is good by Marks, who's been probably one of their most potent players here in the second half. He has seven, no reason to shoot again. And Braintree will close it out here with a 60-42 victory as McNeil running out the final 3 seconds into the hands of Buckley. And that'll do it. A final score here today of 60-42 as Braintree picks up an 18-point victory. And this one ended up being done mostly in the second half. Braintree led by 7 at halftime, 30-23. So they had a seven-point lead at halftime and were able to really make a good mark in the second half and outscore Natick by 11 to win by 18. The game's high score with 17 points was Timberlake, followed behind by Peacock with 10, Novo and Convoy with 9. And Berniski led all scorers for Natick as he had 14 points in the game for the Red Hawks. So Braintree gets to 6-5 on the season, finally over that 500 mark, which they've really desperately fought for, and it's actually the third consecutive win. So it's a big-time win for Braintree now. They'll try and do some home cooking here down the stretch of the season. For the final time here, Braintree picking up the victory, 60-42. For Emily McGrath, I'm Mike Wassel. We'll see you next time.